हेलो माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल LIS एक्सपर्ट। होप सो यू ऑल आर गुड। नाउ दिस इज पार्ट टू ऑफ द लाइब्रेरी ऑटोमेशन। नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू द थ्री वेज ऑफ लाइब्रेरी ऑटोमेशन। फर्स्ट इज अ कन्वर्जन ऑफ इंडिविजुअल ऑपरेशन एट अ टाइम। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इंस्टॉलेशन ऑफ कैटेलॉगिंग मॉड्यूल अलोन टू सर्व what opac serve what opac second point is can be directly fully integrated system to cover the operation of all subsystems in a library. It can be fully integrated system to cover operations of all the subsystems in a library. Third point is that the process can work toward the integration of integrated system progressively using planned installation approach. What approach is using? Planned installation approach. For example, installation of the management member management module and circulation module after the cataloging module. Which module we have installed? Installation of the member management module and circulation module after the cataloging module. So these are the three way of library automation. Now come to the path of the library automation, in which we include ILS. ILS what? Integrated library system. What ILS? Development, or in which we cover development of hardware, software, connectivity along with reduced cost. We have a reduced cost in it, paved the way for integration of library automation system. What way paved? Paved the way of integrated library automation system. Library automation process are integrated system of set of interlinked modules responsible for the management of different operations of module. I am again repeating this. Library automation process are integrated system of set of interlinked module which is responsible for the management of different operational subsystem. Operational subsystem. Now going toward integrated ILA. Integrated ILA are based of the present generation on the basis of web architecture, which based on web architecture, and ILS integrated library system are based on relational databases architecture. On the basis of present generation are based on web architecture, and if we are talking about ILS are based on relational databases architecture. In such a system, files are interlinked. First of all, in that system, files are interlinked, so can deletion and addition and any other change in file automatically activated in the file. Changes in that interlinked file, that related file. Okay. So now come to the three objective of ILS, integrated library system. Come to what? Integrated library system objective. Modern ILS are based on, already I have told you, based upon web enabled identity and or web architecture. Now support three board group of library activity, which support three board group of library. But first is effective housekeeping operation. What? Effective housekeeping operation. Second is sophisticated information retrieval. And third is on the fly Integration of library material with on open databases. On the fly, integration of library material with open databases. For example, I am practically telling you, likewise, if we do searches by author, title and subject, of the library material, so it should show you on a APEX system all the databases of the books and periodicals and other things. This is the example of it. Hope friends, so yeah, this is my video all about second part of the library automation. If I am summing up it in one line, so library automation is what path, if I am summing up in one line with a path of integrating, path of the library automation, one line. So is the development of hardware software connectivity along with reduced cost pave the way, pave the path for the integrated library automation systems. Friend, hope so friends you like my this video. If you like it, please click on bell icon and give your comments so that I can understand you have understood my this video very well way. And if you have any doubt, please write it in the comment section and subscribe my channel too. And hope so all you are good and have a nice day friend, and thank you so much.